Welcome to our tutorial on strategy optimization with Qcaid. In previous videos, we have shown you how to create strategies and how to run backtests on them. In this tutorial, you will learn how to optimize the strategy parameters with the use of variables and the execution of backtest groups. For this tutorial, we will use the RSI strategy that we created in a previous video. This strategy uses bars or candles at a rate of 12 minutes. From this data, we calculate the RSI indicator with a period of 14. The conditions to send a buy order are that the RSI signal crosses below a static value indicating an oversold zone and that we don't already have a long position. When both conditions are met, a buy market order is sent. The condition for closing the position is that the RSI signal exceeds an overbought threshold. To the left of the canvas, we have several views with information on the strategy. This time, we are going to look at the variables view. Variables represent decimal, integer, or Boolean values, which are set at the time of running a backtest or launching an execution. When running a backtest, we can choose to test a range of values for each variable so that we can find its optimal value. Let's see two ways of entering variables. First, we are going to make the oversold threshold a variable value. To replace the original value, we will create a decimal variable by clicking on the button in the variables view. As we can see, the new variable appears on the list. To use it, we simply need to click it and drag it onto our design. Since we no longer need the static value, we select it and press delete to remove it. Instead, we connect the new variable. Let's double-click on the variable to give it a more suitable name. This way, we have replaced a fixed value for a variable. In the same way, variables can also be used as element parameters. For example, we can create a variable to configure the RSI's period. Since the period must be an integer number, we create an integer variable. See how we can also rename the variable by clicking its name in the variable view. To have the RSI use this variable as its period, we double-click on the period value and open the list. Here, we can see all the variables that can be used as a period for the RSI. This is all the integer variables. We select the variable and click its site, and the RSI is configured with the variable we just created. Now that we've added variables to the strategy, let's see how to use them in a backtest. When we click the Upload to Backtest the Strategy button, a configuration form will be displayed where we can enter the test parameters. We change its name to tell it apart from other backtests, and we see that, in addition to the fields we have explained in the previous video, new fields appear for setting the variable values. Checking the test range box allows us to test a range of values. For example, for the oversold threshold, we can set a start value of 25, and value of 30, and step 1, which will take all intermediate values. For the RSI period, 10, 16, and the step of 2 to test all even values from 10 to 16. Click Finish to know how many combinations will run, then click Yes to confirm. After a moment, a notification confirms that the strategy has been successfully uploaded to the server. When we open the report analysis window, we can see that the group is running the 18 backtests and how each of them is being completed. The backtests are executed in dedicated servers and will continue to run even if we disconnect before they are complete. We'll be able to retrieve the results once we reconnect. All the backtest data from the server is automatically synchronized, so there is no need for us to manually download or store the individual backtests. Now that the group execution has finished, we can see a comparison of the individual results by double-clicking on the backtest group. Here we can see a number of statistics on the performance of the strategy for each combination of the values for oversold threshold and RSI period. To find the best value, click on any of them to see a comparison chart. In this case, the 10th backtest got the best results. We can see all its details by double-clicking on it, including the particular variable values with which it was executed. Once we have identified the best performing parameters, it is advisable to test them in a high-precision backtest. We will see how to do this in the next video. I'll see you there. Thank you for watching.